Hey guys, before the video starts, I want you to go ahead and go into the link in the description below and follow a friend of mine by the name of GTA GFX. Now, the reason why I state this is because not only he's a beautifully well done Photoshop creator and design creator as well, he's also made the GTA Online Gunrunning DLC logo available for us to use in the link in one of his tweets, if I'm not mistaken. And I wanted to go ahead and give him his spotlight because, you know, he went through the process of being able to do that for us so that we could use it for our phones or, in this case, a video. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And once again, go to GTA GFX's Twitter handle and go ahead and follow him because he does a lot of good work. Other than that, peace. New DLC. The time where you blow your money on stuff that's fun at first but meaningless after about 2 weeks, and you're stuck doing nothing but selling stock that takes longer than a grandma at a grocery store with her wallet full of pennies. The DLC in this case, Gunrunning. Now, being very similar to the CEO in cars or the biker in their drugs, this time you'll be tasked with selling weaponry across Los Santos while making a buck or two on the side, which will probably take about a pretty long eternity to do so. But that's not actually what I'm here to talk about. No. I'm actually quite interested in something a bit more different. Now, if you're looking for tips and tricks on how to make money fast or to get a good look at what content is available in the game, then I highly recommend going to GTA series videos, since they are a hell of a lot better at doing showcases for the game than I am. And if you're probably wondering if I'm interested in any of the content available at all, then no need to worry, because I am, regardless of how expensive it can be. Now, I'm telling you this straight up, if you don't have at least 10 to 12 million in your pockets, then you're basically out of luck, Chuck. Now, from my personal experience, the missions are a blast, especially with your friends. You can literally crack open a cold one with the boys while blowing stuff up and looking awesome while doing so. And the vehicles, I'm not gonna lie, aren't too shabby, you know. Even though one of your boys happened to hit you with said vehicle and leave you behind during the mission and try to lie when you call them out on it. I mean, it's a hell of a lot better than being in a lobby with randoms who make fun of your ability to actually shoot a cannon, even though you've been trying to do your best to help them out throughout the whole mission, you know, carry them in your backpack, so to speak. But that's not really what grasped my attention throughout this whole DLC. What really caught my eye were the new MK2 versions of 6 existing weapons already in the game, and these weapons are the pistol, SMG, assault rifle, carbine rifle, combat MG, and the heavy sniper rifle. And by God, they are looking glorious in their MK2 versions. They honestly look sick. Correct me if I'm wrong, but in order to purchase the MK2 variants of the weapons, you have to have a mobile operations center with a weapon modification section inside the MOC. It can be bought from the Warstock website on your phone. Well, you know, your in-game phone. And once you've done this, you can basically purchase the variants for a reasonable price for about 50k and up, the highest being about 150,000 for the heavy sniper. And after this, you have tons of customization options that, you know, you can choose from, which is different types of ammo, muzzle brakes, and tents and liveries, or liveries, whatever you want to call it. And there are so many tents, I can't even imagine how much it would cost to purchase all of them, because all of them are basically about 50k and up. Two of them are locked because you have to go to the shooting range, but that'll be explained later in the video. But I'm not going to go into specifics over this, but you have to actually unlock some of them through the research and development center. Now, once you've begun your business, you have to wait till the research gauge is actually filled up using the supplies you already acquired, and you can, you know, purchase them if you like to, you know, the supplies. But it's like, nah. You can also do the same thing with the research, but it's like, nah as well, because you're gonna pay a lot of money for it. And once the research gauge does fill up, it's like the surprise lottery. You're not gonna know what you're gonna get, so you gotta be very consistent with it, especially if you want to get like certain weapon attachments or, you know, stuff for your vehicles, the modifications and all that stuff. And the final thing I want to talk about is the shooting range. It's very strenuous, but it's also rewarding at the same time. It's going to consume up a lot of time, but you just got to be calm and patient throughout the whole process. Otherwise, you're going to end up getting frustrated, and, you know, that's not really good for your health, because you may end up dying from a heart attack, which I almost did because of this damn thing. But I digress on the whole situation. Now, there are 3 tiers for each weapon available, and in order to reap the rewards, you have to pass the minimal score requirements. And once again, it's going to take up a lot of time. And just so you don't have to search all this stuff up on the internet on what you're going to get, I'm going to go ahead and tell you guys. The first tier rewards consist of the metallic, gold, and platinum tints for your MK2 variant weapons. Now, that may not seem a lot, but you know, it's like, you know, if you want to put some extra bling on your weapons, there you go. The second tier rewards consist of an increased capacity of how many explosives you can carry. You basically unlock more explosives in your arsenal, up to 30, and this does include the Molotovs and tear gas. So if you don't like blowing people up, but instead setting them on fire, or, you know, throwing tear gas at their face, making them cry, and then proceed to shoot them in the head, then there you go. And the third tier rewards consist of exclusive clothing items that you gain from completing all tier challenges. 12 pieces in total. Now, these are 3 caps, 6 tees, and 3 hoodies. And I haven't had a chance to actually look at them yet, because after unlocking them, I was like, meh, because I was trying to focus on most of my stuff, you know, the stock and all that stuff, because them research gauges take way too long, and it's like, god damn, I have other stuff to do besides this. But yeah, I'll be sure to, like, I don't know, probably post pictures or something about it later, or maybe someone else probably already did, or maybe GTA series probably already did, you know, some of that stuff as well. Speaking of that, GTA series videos also has 2 videos of the shooting ranges for the new Gunrunning DLC. Now, if you want to go ahead and check that out, the links will be in the description below, because they are masterminds when it comes to this stuff. I believe they already have a guide for it, as well as a 3-star tier challenge on how to get the 3 stars in each tier. So if you want to go ahead and drop on by the channel, you know, give them a like, go ahead and give them a sub, because they are really fantastic when it comes to Grand Theft Auto Online, as well as any other Rockstar game created. So there's that. But other than that, I hope you guys actually enjoyed the video, because, you know, been a long time since I actually done a GTA video. Last one I done was probably, like, I don't know, for OG Loke and all that other stuff. Don't at me on that, by the way. But other than that, you guys have a very pleasant day, and just keep on practicing, keep on trying to get all this stuff, and just enjoy yourself. Screw it. Also, if you see any Hydras in the lobby, be sure to take them out with the, you know, explosive rounds for the heavy MK sniper, because it's about time we strike back. Hard.